Hi everyone, my name is Zakithi and I'm a scientist. I'm actually a microbiologist, geneticist, virologist, and molecular biologist. I'm pretty sure if you didn't know what I do or what I'm here to talk to you about, not many of you would believe me. When I say the word scientist, do you think of this guy? Albert Einstein died over 70 years ago, yet he still remains the face of science. Is it because of his theory of relativity, which changed our perception of time, space, gravity, and the universe? Well, I'm not going to get into too much about how Albert Einstein became the face of science, but rather why he remains there. Scientists today come in all colors, all nationalities, and yet the idea of a scientist still remains this one. A quick Google search did indeed give that Albert Einstein is the undisputed face of science. Growing up, we subscribed to so many different stereotypes. Girls were not expected to become mechanics. Men were not expected to become nurses. So much so that when a man is a nurse, they're referred to as a male nurse, when in fact the definition of a nurse is a person who takes care of the sick. There are many stereotypes which also exist about scientists, that we're nerds, a little socially awkward, don't have great fashion sense, and that our whole lives revolve around our career. All of which is not true for all of us. So what is wrong with these stereotypes? We are currently living through the fourth industrial revolution, and it is absolutely unreasonable to assume that more than half of the world's population will not be assuming a position in this. We are still seeing many gender disparities in women taking science subjects, where there's an average ratio of 1 in 5 woman to man taking a particular subject. And even if a woman does take a particular science subject, research has shown that they do not go on to further their studies and assume positions in academia. It is as if the black woman is almost invisible in this space. Growing up, a few years ago in my country, a lot of black people were told no, just because of the color of their skin. But I'm going to demonstrate to you how black women have made some of the most life-changing discoveries. Katherine G. Johnson was a black American mathematician whose complex calculations in orbital mechanics led to the success of the first US crewed spaceflight. Furthermore, her calculations were also crucial in the 1960 space missions as well as the 1969 moon landing. Dr. Wangari Maathai is a Kenyan activist and politician, and one of the most impactful environmentalists. She was the first black female professor in her home country of Kenya, and she was the first African woman recipient of the Nobel Peace Prize. In 1977, she led the Greenbelt movement to counter deforestation. Thanks to her, 51 million trees have been planted in Kenya. I am currently doing my PhD in medicine, which is one of the most advanced degrees to do, and a qualification that less than 1% of South Africans' population have. More often than not, I'm the youngest black female candidate in the room, and I constantly have to prove myself at every turn. In 2018, I embarked on my Master of Medical Science, and I got to present my research findings for the very first time on an international platform. So I was very excited, and I packed my bags, and off I went to Canada. It was freezing cold, and it was my first ever experience of snow. So I arrived at the ski resort, and I checked into the hotel room, which was booked for me, and the next day at breakfast was going to be my first encounter of the conference delegates. So I went down to breakfast, and I encountered a lot of Albert Einstein-looking characters, and a few female counterparts. Another culture shock for me as a PhD candidate was when I went to San Francisco on my first research visit. And I arrived at the building security only to be interrogated about why I was there. So you can see that when a scientist like me shows up, It's never assumed that I am one. As society, it's time that we stop raising our eyebrows when someone tells us that they're scientists and they do not fit into what society has told us a scientist looks like. To rip the idea to shreds and to create a whole new one, all for the benefit of society. I think you will agree with me in saying that it is time to change the face of science. Science is not a white man thing, it's not a white woman thing, it's not a boy thing, it's not a girl thing, it's a people thing. Thank you.